to one who was with me in the war. It was too long ago, that company we served with. We call it back in visual fragments, you and I, who seem ourselves like relics casually preserved with our mindfulness of old bombardments, when the sky with blundering din blinked cavernous. Yet a sense of power invades us when recapturing an ungodly hour of anti-zero crisis, in one thought we've met, to stand in some redoubt of time, to share again all but the actual wetness of the flare-lit rain, all but the living presences who haunt us yet with gloom patrolling eyes. Remembering, we forget much that was monstrous, much that clogged our souls with clay, when ours were guides who led us by the longest way, and when the worst had been endured could still disclose another worst to thwart us. We forget our fear, and while the uncouth event begins to lower less near, discern the mad magnificence whose stormlight throws wild shadows on these afterthoughts that send your brain back beyond peace, exploring sunken, ruinous roads. Your brain, with files of flitting forms humpbacked with loads, on its own helmet hears the tinkling drops of rain, follows to an end some night relief, and strangely sees the quiet no man's land of daybreak, jagged with trees that loom like giant Germans. I'll go with you then, since you must play this game of ghosts. At listening posts, we'll peer across dim craters, joke with jaded men whose names we've long forgotten. Stoop low there, it's the place the sniper enfilades. Round the next bay you'll meet a drenched platoon commander. Chilled, he drums his feet on squelching duckboards, winds his wristwatch, turns his head, and shows you how you looked, your 10 years vanished face, hoping the war will end next week. What's that you said?